ready to get started. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the NCAA Read to the Final Four announcement of our Final Four schools. This is so exciting. We are coming to you this morning live from Skyline High School in Dallas, Texas. Woo! I'm Laura Jenkins, and I'm with Dallas ISD's Reading Language Arts Department. And this morning, we're going to hear from our awesome sponsors, the NCAA and the Dallas Sports Commission, watch a cool NCAA video, we're going to play a little game, and then we're going to find out which four schools have read their way to the Final Four. Okay, and now I'd like to introduce Victor Hill from the NCAA.
Thank you, Laura. It is such a privilege to be here today. Again, my name is Victor Hill, and I work for the National Collegiate Athletic Association. How many of you guys are going to go to college one day? Raise your hands. All right, that's what I love to see. Our job, we work with over 3,000 colleges, and we're specifically in charge of 400,000 student athletes, to the ones who play sports in school. They dedicate themselves every year to working hard in the classroom and working hard at their particular sport. So I have a special video that we're going to show you right now of some of the collegiate sports around the country and our student athletes. Take a look at this video.
Get out of that tunnel, hear that crowd roar, soak that in, smell the roses, and let's get going.
Going to the end zone, touchdown! Make it five straight for Fargo.
The national championship goes to Connecticut for the fourth year in a row as the dynasty fulfills its destiny.
It's Page off balance, puts it up.
Jenkins for the championship.
Now, isn't that exciting? This is one of the most fun jobs that we can have in the world, to work with these student athletes. And how many of you know at the end of this month, something very special is going to happen right here in Dallas? On March 31st and April 2nd, we are going to crown a Division I women's basketball champion right here in Dallas. If you look over there, if you take a look over there, you'll see the championship trophy that you saw them raising over there. So one of the universities is going to win that trophy. But guess what? That's not why we're here today. We are here today to celebrate the outstanding work that you guys have done, the outstanding work with reading. And on a count of three, I want you to give yourselves the loudest cheer that you can for what you accomplished. One, two, three. Yeah. That is great. We are so proud of what you guys have done. We're proud because we know you've dedicated yourselves to read, and I know you've had a lot of fun. Reading is so exciting and it's so fun. As I mentioned to you, we have over 400,000 student athletes, and guess what? All of them at one time were third graders just like you. And what helped them get there was the fact that they love to read. When you read, you can accomplish anything. You can accomplish your goals. So keep up the great, great work. We're really proud of you. And guess what? That weekend when we crown that champion, we're going to crown a second champion first. We're going to crown a reading champion out of this room right here. So keep reading hard, keep working, and all of you are winners every day that you read. Thanks a lot.
Exciting, exciting. I am Monica Paul. I'm the Executive Director of the Dallas Sports Commission. This is a very special day because I get to see all the progress that y'all have made since our kickoff to the Read to the Final Four since November. From a Sports Commission standpoint, our job in the community is to bid and secure these major sporting events to our city. So, like a Super Bowl or the Women's Final Four, as Victor said. But another part of hosting these major events is the part that gives back to the community and the ability to provide these types of reading and literacy programs right back here in the community that we live in. I'm very excited to partner with DISD on this program and very excited to see all the progress that y'all have made in reading and all of the minutes and the books. We've got a lot of great incentives that I think you're going to be giving out, and looking forward to seeing on March 31st who the champion is of the Read to the Final Four program. So next up, I'm going to introduce Leisha Thompson. She is our Women's Final Four Ambassador. She is played women's basketball at Texas Tech and in the WNBA. Alicia?
All right, thank you, Monica. Thank you guys for allowing me to be here. So we're gonna play a game. How many of you guys have heard of the game Simon Says? Simon Says? Okay, well, Simon's not here, so I'm gonna be standing in Simon's place today, so today is gonna be Coach T Says, okay? So for those of you that do not know the rules, the rules of the game is I'm going to shout a command. If I shout the command and I don't say Coach T Says before the command and you do the command, then you're out. If I say Coach T Says, pat your head, and you pat your head, then you stay in the game. If I say, pat your head, you're not supposed to pat your head because I didn't say Coach T Says. So for a good maybe 5 minutes, I get to tell you guys all what to do and you have to listen or you lose. No, I'm just joking. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna have everybody stand up. Coach T didn't say. No. Everybody lost before we even got started. No, we're all winners here. Just joking. Coach T says, stand up. All right, since you guys have been sitting down, I know we have a lot of energy. So I know sometimes I want to move around and can't. And you guys are third graders, so I know you want to move around. So everybody, Coach T says, let's shake it out. Here we go. Oh, yeah. Shake out those arms. Nice, nice, nice. And stop. Oh, if you guys stop. Okay, let's time out. Coach T says time out. This is a game built on integrity. So if you know that you stop, you have to be fair and sit down because I can't see everybody, okay? So if you stop, go ahead and sit down for me, okay? Be honest. Be honest. I may not be able to see, but somebody's watching. Okay, nice job, guys. All right, let's continue. So Coach T says, continue shaking out your arms. Here we go. And Coach T says, jump while you shake your arm in your place. Come on, shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. Coach T says, stop. Pat your belly. Oh, I saw a few pat your belly. That's right. So we have some coaches over here, my assistant coaches. They're watching everybody. Okay, and let's, Coach T says pat your head. Let's pat your head. Or pat your weave. Just joking. You guys don't have weave. And Coach T says stop. Coach T says, look at your neighbor and say, read every day. Say it again, read every day. Coach T didn't say. All right. Good job. So we're starting to dwindle down a little bit. All right. Coach T says dab. Yeah, nice. Oh, I see the teachers getting in on this. They were waiting for that one. Nice job. Coach T says, look at your neighbor and say, I love the Final Four. Okay, nice, nice. Coach T says, yawn. Nice, okay. You guys are getting good at this. Coach T says, stomp your feet. Stop. Oh. Come on, guys. Let's be honest. Let's be honest. That's right. Okay. So we're going down a little bit more. Let's look at your neighbor and say, I love your shades. Okay, we're still calling people out. Okay, look at your neighbor and say, I love your shades. Oh, they're still stomping their feet over here. Okay, Coach T says, say, I love my teacher. Nice. And sit down. Okay, raise your hand. Coach T says, raise your hand. Raise your foot. Coach T says, raise your foot. Put your arm down. Oh, I saw some over there. And high five your neighbor. Coach T says, high five your neighbor. Good job. I have a great one. This is going to be perfect for you guys. Let's just go ahead and shake your whole body now. Shake your whole body. Shake it, shake it, shake it. Coach T says, shake your whole body. Wiggle, wiggle, keep going and stop. Oh, I saw a whole bunch of people over here. Coach T says, stop. Remember, guys, be honest. Okay, so if you're still playing in the game, I'm trying to figure out how many people are in the game here. So if you're still playing the game, go ahead and sit down. Oh, you guys are good. You guys are really good. Okay, Coach T says sit down. Coach T says stand back up. Coach T says sit down. Coach T says, stand back up. And last time, sit down. Ah! So, not only are you guys awesome readers, you're also awesome listeners. I love it. Okay, let's, Coach T says, dribble the basketball. Let's dribble with that right hand. Oh, yeah. And Coach T says, shoot a shot. Let's shoot a shot. You guys see my form. It's still good. See that? See that, Coach Mays? Still teaching that. And stop. Coach T says stop. and as loud as you can. I want everybody to say, I love women's basketball. On three. Oh! All right, good job, guys. Great job. So everybody stand up. Coach T says stand up. The game is over, so now you can listen. And I want everybody to give yourself a big round of applause. Good job, guys. Thank you very much, and Coach T says sit down. Okay. Thank you very much. All right, guys, so now I would like to bring to the stage the senior commissioner of the associate commissioner of the Big 12. She is a four-time letter winner in basketball, a two-time letter winner in tennis. She's also a doubles tennis champion, but she plays a huge role for the Big 12 conference. She's coming from Panama City. Is anybody from Florida in here? Florida? Nice. So she's representing you Florida guys, okay? And she does a lot of things for the Big 12. She has a lot to do with the selection sites for the teams. So you guys give a nice, big, warm welcome to Drew Hancock.
Thanks, Alicia. I hate to follow you, but I've got the big job here today. I've got the moment that everyone has been waiting for. Is everybody ready? I'm going to name the final four schools in the Read to the Final Four competition. If I call your name and you're here, I want you to stand up and go a little crazy, okay? The first school is Highland Meadows. Congratulations. The next school is Jose Jomé. Way to go, readers, way to go. The third school is Pleasant Grove. Guess who the next school is? T.G. Terry. Congratulations to each and every one of you and your teachers. We have some awesome readers here today. And now it's my pleasure to introduce a very special guy, a great player, played in the NBA, was drafted by the Sacramento Kings, played professionally for 12 years, great coach now, coached at a Big 12 school, the University of Texas, for a number of years as associate head coach. And as I said, a great player and a great coach, but a better guy. Give it up for the head coach of the women's basketball team at SMU, Travis Mays.
Good morning, good morning. How's everybody doing? Just good, how about great? Okay, let me try that again. How's everybody doing? That's what I'm talking about. Ladies and gentlemen, let me ask you a question. Did you know you were going to come here and meet someone special today?
No.
Coach T played in the WNBA. How many of you in here would like to be a professional athlete one day? Raise your hand. Wow, that's a lot. That's a lot. So are you going to go back to your school today and tell your friends who were unable to be here today that you met some special people? Will you? Okay, now there's a reason that you were able to meet these special people and do these special things today. It's because you were competitive, you were disciplined, and you did it over a period of time to where you reached the Final Four. So give yourselves a hand. Let me tell you what the treat is for me today, ladies and gentlemen. The treat is for me to meet you, because in my mind, you outcompeted everybody else to be here at the Final Four. That makes you a superstar. Okay, I want you to know that. Okay, that's how it starts. And it starts by you being given a task, you having the discipline to complete that task over a period of time, and then when you compete and you tally up, you become the winner. Now, I know there's still four teams in here. By a round of applause or a cheer, which team is going to win it and be the absolute champion? Okay. Time out. Let me ask you one more time, because I don't think everybody understood. If you feel like your team is going to be the champion, I want you to stand up and cheer as loud as you can. Who's going to be the champion? Okay. All right. Oh, I like it. Okay. Okay. I'm absolutely loving this because I can feel a competitive spirit. And man, this is going to be a tough competition. But let me say something to you. It all starts with you being coachable, meaning once you get the assignment and you apply it, that means you stick to it. That's how you win. That's the discipline of winning. I am so proud of each and every school that's here today representing the Final Four. So continue to listen to your teachers, continue to work hard, and I promise you, this is what I was told as a third grader. If I continue to read, I continue to listen, which means be coachable, and I do that over a consistent period of time, that's how I was able to become a professional basketball player. If you guys notice, I'm not that tall. I'm not that tall, but I listened very hard, and I was very respectful, and I was disciplined. And I'm going to tell you today before I leave, once again, I know there's going to be a lot of prizes given out, but I also want to extend the prize myself. Remind your teachers to make sure that they call the SMU Women's Basketball Office, because with the excitement and enthusiasm that you show, I want to invite each and every one of you to a women's basketball game. Okay. So you just have them call. Once they call, we're going to put you on the list, but it's only under two conditions. You continue to read, and you bring your loud, cheering voice to the arena. Can you do that? Awesome. Well, I wish you all the best of luck. And over there, I have some posters of this year's current team and another couple of prizes that I want to give you. So make sure that each and every one of you get one of those so you can remember. So by show of hands, how many are going to remember to tell their teacher to call our office to get tickets to come watch us play next year? Awesome. Well, then I will be looking forward to you coming to Moody Coliseum, and I want to personally say hello to you when you get to the gym, all right? Good luck, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for having me.
Exciting. I didn't even know y'all were going to get that opportunity. Okay, well, I am back with some exciting news. Now we have come to the time where we're going to find out what incentives you all are going to receive. And do you know what incentives mean? Prizes. These are going to be prizes. Okay, so our first prize, each school is going to receive $1,000 for their library. Isn't that wonderful? Okay, so let's remember all these prizes are coming from the NCAA and the Dallas Sports Commission. Okay, if I can get our school representatives that we have here today to come up here on stage. So from Highland Meadows, we have Principal Davis. Okay, if you can come on up, Mr. Davis. Yes. Mm-hmm. And from Joe May, Principal Rivera. Okay, and representing Pleasant Grove, we have the librarian, Miss McClung. And from T.G. Terry, Principal Bradley. Okay, and I want to tell everyone that earlier this week they had the some awards on television, and they had a little mistake with one of their awards, but there is no mistake with any of our awards. We have checked everything. Okay, now we're getting ready to award our teachers. So we have one teacher from each school that's going to be recognized for the awesome reading that their students have done. Okay, let me tell you what these teachers are going to get. So each teacher is going to receive $100 in school supplies and a tablet for their classroom. Isn't that exciting? Okay, y'all can go on down this way. All right, are we ready to find out who these teachers are? Okay. All right, so teachers, if you could please come forward when we call your name. Our first teacher from Highland Meadows, Ms. Rocio Mateo. Okay, next, from Joe May, Ms. Susanna Rodriguez. Okay, from Pleasant Grove, Mr. Luis Puente. Okay, we have one more teacher from T.G. Terry, Ms. Jilma Selman. Okay, let's have a round of applause for all our wonderful teachers. Okay, now this is really exciting. We have something for our top readers. These are the students from all over the district, not necessarily a Final Four school, who have read the most minutes so far in the competition. We have three of those students here today. So each of these great readers, you know what? I'm gonna wait till you get up here and we'll announce what you're gonna get. So if I call your name, please come forward. Y'all ready? From Highland Meadows, James Perez. Okay, from Joe May, Gerardo Ortiz. And from Pleasant Grove, Daisy Navarro. OK, Okay, let's get these students up here and find out what they're going to get. Come on up here. Okay, now we don't have it here today, but each one of these students is going to receive a brand new bike. Isn't that exciting? Okay, but wait, there's more. Okay, so we have one final incentive our sponsors, the NCAA and the Dallas Sports Commission, are providing. They are so proud of the great reading you have been doing and all the awesome minutes that you're accumulating that they have decided that every single third grader in each of these schools is going to receive a $20 Amazon gift card. Isn't that wonderful? Each and every one of you. Okay, let's hear it for our awesome sponsors. Let's hear it for our awesome sponsors, the NCAA and the Dallas Sports Commission. Okay, so we will announce the Read to the Final Four champion, the school that will receive the trophy over there that Mr. Hill showed you. We will announce that school on March 31st. Now, let me give you a little preview of what that school is going to receive. $2,000 for the library, a tablet, an Amazon Echo, and a $1,000 gift card for supplies for the top classroom. A laptop for the teacher of the top classroom, and every student at the school will get this really cool Wilson NCAA Women's Final Four backpack. So those are provided by Wilson. Okay, then the top reader in the district is going to get a plaque identifying that they're the top reader, two tickets to the NCAA Women's Final Four, a Women's Final Four Lucite ticket that they can save, and a floor piece just like they will use at the Women's Final Four, and a tablet. Okay, so we want to congratulate everyone who received a prize, and hey, that's every single person in here, isn't it? So let's have a big cheer for all our prizes. And now we're going to bring back Coach T, and she is going to do the reading pledge with you.
All right, third graders, so you guys have been doing a really good job reading every day. That's why you're here, okay, as the Final Four. And now we're going to take the reading pledge. So if you guys will, stand with me. So we'll all be saying the pledge together, and again, this is a pledge that you all can read every single day. So when you say this, make sure that you say it with some meaning and some sincerity that you're really going to do this, okay? Oh, it's repeat. Okay. You guys, if you will, repeat after me. I am a reader.
I am a reader.
Readers become leaders.
I will read each morning.
Day and night.
Day and night.
I will read everything within my sight.
I will read everything within my sight.
I am a reader.
I am a reader.
Readers become leaders.
Readers become leaders.
I will read things that make me smile.
I will read things that make me smile.
I will read enough words to extend a mile.
I will read enough words to extend a mile.
I am a reader.
Readers become leaders.
I will read to make me smarter.
I will read to make my thinking go farther.
I am a reader.
And as loud as you can, readers become leaders.
Nice. Good job, guys. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. So that was great. We know that you're going to read every day. So as we conclude this, we'd like to say a big thank you to the Dallas Skyline High School for allowing us to come and be in your building today, for hosting us. A big thank you to the NCAA Teamworks and the Dallas Sports Commission for coming out and supporting this event. And let's give a big round of applause to the Dallas Skyline cheerleaders and the drumline and the band. They were simply awesome. And last thing, guys, you guys were awesome. Please continue to read. That concludes the event for the day. Everybody have a good day. Remember, keep reading, guys. Great job today. Thank you.
Please make sure to take your reading pledges with you, because we don't want to have to pick those up. Do we still need some people up? Do we still need principals for pictures? Jane? Oh, do we still need our principals for pictures? Are we done with pictures? Okay. Okay, I think we have everything. Thank you all so much for coming. Oh, hang on. We do have for two of our schools, Highland Meadows has already received their books. We have books here.